Before computers and digital cameras, movies were edited by hand. Editors would get rolls of raw film and physically cut and paste the scenes together. This process was called splicing. But what does this old editing technique have to do with human disease? It runs in the family. Chances are, you've heard this phrase before. Today, we know that the biological details of our bodies are passed down from our parents. This includes physical traits, like your hair color or height, but also your susceptibility to certain kinds of disease. All this information is encoded in your DNA. DNA is made up of four nucleotide bases, A, G, C, and T, that spell out the information a cell needs to carry out the functions of life. These are organized into units called genes. Now, every cell in your body contains workers called ribosomes. Ribosomes build proteins, and each protein carries out a specific task in the cell. However, ribosomes need instructions every time they put together a protein. Inside every cell, there's a nucleus, and inside every nucleus, there's a copy of your DNA. Think of the nucleus as a media center. It produces tutorials that teach ribosomes how to build proteins. And right now, we need to build a protein to strengthen the walls of the nucleus. We'll call it Protein X. Imagine your DNA is a strip of film. From here to here is one gene. Inside this gene is the whole tutorial for building Protein X. But how do we make the tutorial? First, the nucleus copies this gene. This copy is called RNA and can be read by the ribosome. The original DNA stays in the nucleus and is preserved for future reference. But the tutorial is not ready yet because the footage is scattered around the gene. Part of it is here, another part is here, another part is here. These frames of footage are called exons. The film strip also contains frames that aren't part of the video. These sequences are called introns and will not be in the final tutorial. One of their purposes is to provide instructions on how and where to edit the film. This is the spliceosome. Think of it as a film editor. It follows directions in the introns, cuts them out, and pastes the exons together. This entire process is known as splicing. Now we have a coherent tutorial video that can be relayed to the ribosomes. Splicing is crucial to the correct construction of proteins. Unfortunately, mistakes can occur as a result of mutations. Mutations are variations from the nucleotide sequences in our original DNA. We used to think only mutations in the movie frames themselves caused disease. But now, we know that mutations that affect the splicing process can also cause disease. Back to Protein X. If there are no mutations in the film, Protein X will look like this and fit perfectly into the structure. But let's say there's a mutation in the film frames. This might cause Protein X to have a little hole in it, like this. When it slots in, it leaves a gap in the wall, and you get a slightly weaker structure. Now, let's say there's a splicing mutation, a mutation in the instructional frames. This will cause the organization of the video to be altered. Some scenes might be missing, others might be cut short, and others may include unnecessary segments of film. This will have a much bigger effect on how Protein X is built. The finished protein might have an entire region missing, like this. Keep in mind that this is happening in many cells at once, so imagine the kinds of damage that splicing mutations can do. So why is splicing important? Experts estimate that 1/3 of all heritable disease involves an error in splicing. Still, we don't have a detailed understanding of how exactly splicing goes wrong. Part of the problem is that each person has about 3 million unique differences in their DNA, so it's hard to tell which ones cause disease. Today, researchers are using computers and statistics to comb through mountains of mutations and model their effects on splicing. We hope to find patterns that tell us how splicing is directed. Eventually, doctors may be able to come up with personalized treatments by studying the mutations that affect how our genetic tutorials are edited.
Thank you.